Pounds won, I end up.
It was decent. After last year, we lost 5-5 here. Well, not here, but against Stranraer. We lost 5-0 here. And I did think as the season went on, we did improve and we got closer to them. And I watched Stranraer 2 weeks ago up here against them and still knew they were a strong side. So it's a terrific result for us, but I thought it was well deserved.
1.5 half
time, it could have been 3. Aye, it could have been. I mean, I was a wee bit worried when we missed that early chance with Shane, because you don't get chances much better than that sometimes, but we kept at it, and I mean, I thought our work rate was fantastic, and, you know, we've got a good balance to our team at the minute, so it's good.
It's a good message to send out as well, coming down here and a wee clean sheet for goals.
It is. I mean, considering two of your back four, when they hear that our captain is injured, our other centre-half was suspended, so, you know, it's given me a good problem, that's for sure, because the guys that are coming in have played well. We've not got a big squad, but I feel as though we've got a decent quality squad, and, you know, it's just good. After we had a disappointing performance last week, where I felt we could still have won the game coming back for 2-2, but when I analysed it, we didn't have enough players playing well, and I said, well, if we turn up, we'll be a handful for any team, and we turned up today. So it was terrific.
Very so. I never saw that coming, but it's certainly a wake up call for us, you know. So Peterhead, to be fair, looked as if they were up for more than us, which is a big surprise, you know, especially on their own ground. So certainly a bad day at the office.
It looked like after a slow start, you could have been a couple of goals down early on and then struggled to get back into it.
Well, I mean, they had a couple of chances. I mean, obviously, enough free kicks, three free kicks we've lost, three goals from in the middle of the 18 yard. So disappointed there. So in the end, yeah, we had a couple of chances to sell with Mark McGugan through and stuff. And it's a bad recipe if you're not defending properly and you're not taking your chances. That's what can happen. But I don't think it was down to that. I just thought Peterhead looked hungrier, looked more aggressive, bigger, stronger. They wanted it more than us, worked harder, which is. It's certainly no like us at all, so that's the biggest disappointment for us, you know, and it compounded it just with the scores, and we kind of gifted a couple of goals, certainly the second one, and the fourth one, we just seemed to switch off, albeit we were making subs and we were trying to gamble a wee bit and push men forward, but certainly very poor. But I mean, 2-0 down, we probably should be 2-1, because Kearney should score there, you know, and it's a different game, you know, as I say, goals change games, but that'd probably been a wee bit unfair, because I don't think we probably deserved that. But as I say, if you don't take your chances and you don't give yourself a wee lift, then that's what happens, and it did today, unfortunately. So, but we've got to react, and I certainly spoke to him about that, and I need big reactions for next week, because it's certainly nowhere near good enough, and it's just certainly not like, because it's very uncharacteristic. So I'm looking for big performances next week.
You're right, it probably is a wake-up call, because you got the win against Denny, a cracking was late win last week. It looked like everything was sort of rolling along quite nicely.
Yeah, as I said to them, I reiterated to them every week, you can't just turn up and think you're going to win, and it looked a wee bit like that today. I think we just maybe believed the hype, and we're on a good run, and Peterhead, a long journey, come down here, we just don't need to maybe put the same effort and commitment in as we did, and as I say, it looked that way, and as I say, Peterhead, certainly credit to them, looked as if they were very, very much up for it, and they were big and strong and aggressive and causes problems, but as I say, that's what you'll get in this division if we don't react and respond in the right manner. That can happen. It can happen to any team in this division, for and against, you know. So it happened to us today, unfortunately, but hopefully that's the one that we've had that won't happen again.
Does it mean make changes for next game?
Well, I mean, we've not got 10 players we can bring in yet, not unfortunately, but as I said, I'm fair minds are that way. I'll give them a chance to rectify the poor performance today, and I know with the characters in there, I'm looking for that response. If it continues, obviously, then he'll look to try and bring one or two in. But we are still looking to try and bring one or two in, because we're a wee bit light in squad. But that's no excuse for today. We were just second best.
Good to see Paul Kenny come on, and he did show in flashes what he's capable of, and his set piece delivery was excellent as well.
Yeah, I mean, I think Paul, as yourself, you've still got to get yourself up to speed in terms of fitness, you know. So we're trying to kind of nurse him along with that, you know. But the stage of the season that you can't carry people, you need to have it to be 100%, and we need to probably get him up to 100%, because he's got just a wee bit to go in that. So, but yeah, I think he's, as I say, he's an experienced big player for us, and hopefully he can play a part this season. But there's other good players in there today, and they just never really turned up, as I said. So that was a big surprise. It was a wake up call for me also, because I never expected to see that. Albeit, as I say, I think the scoreline can flatter them, because we shot ourselves in the foot with a couple of poor defensive decisions, and we looked as if we were feeling sorry for ourselves, which again is a wee bit uncharacteristic for us. So as I say, I'm looking for a big reaction next week.
Just looking ahead to next week, obviously it's a fixture you know fairly well.
Yeah, well, exactly. I mean obviously it gives it a wee bit of added edge as well, because obviously I've got a few players in there who are ex-Air United, you know, but that doesn't look really come into it, you know. I'm obviously with Stranraer now, and I want obviously the best for us, and hopefully, as I say, we'll get a reaction. Well, I'm demanding a reaction, to be honest with you, because if we play in that manner again and don't turn up, then, as I say, it can happen to anybody, it can happen again, so I certainly don't want that to happen.
I imagine, purely from a fan's point of view, that it's arguably the game they look forward to the most each season. It's as close to a derby as you're going to get, and it's a perfect chance to ring today.
Well, as I say, I think the fans are performers after that. You know, I think we're way off it today, and there's too many players not the races today, so we're looking for a big reaction from everybody, myself included. You know, I'm part of the team, you know, and we can only apologise for the supporters today, but I'll make sure it doesn't happen again. And the players in there, as I say, good characters, and I'm sure they'll knuckle down and they'll put on a good performance next week, and hopefully we can forget with this one.
That's good.